Hello?
Hey.
Hey. I'm surprised you're calling me.
Honestly, so am I.
You didn't seem too happy last night.
No, I didn't.
Well, are you feeling better?
Am I feeling better?
Yeah. Are you?
Do you have any idea why I called?
To talk?
Yeah, that's why a person would call another person.
Okay. Did you want to talk about last night?
No, you know what? I don't. I just want to pretend like it didn't happen and move on.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yes, I want to talk about it, you fucking idiot.
Okay, what? What is it?
You are unbelievable.
I don't understand. I didn't do anything wrong.
No, you didn't, Brandon. You never do anything wrong.
Okay, I'll bite at the sarcasm. What's that supposed to mean?
It means you constantly screw up and you don't apologize for it. Like, you know, he was really hurt by what you said last night, Brandon. He really, really looks up to you.
All right, well, it's not my fault that your little brother can't take a joke.
Well, he didn't think it was a joke, okay? Can you grasp that? Can you grasp that, I don't know, maybe people can get hurt by what you say, even if it was a joke?
No, I don't. I really don't. I don't think anybody can get offended by something if it's a joke. I was joking, Angie.
Oh my God, you know what? Whatever this thing is that we're doing, we're stopping it.
What do you mean?
This, whatever this shit is that we're doing, I can't do it anymore.
What? Why?
Because you don't know why!
Angie, and oh my fucking God, Jesus, okay. Jason, I'm gonna have to call you back, man. I'm in a bit of an emergency.
Hey, man, what are you doing?
I just told you I was in an emergency.
Yeah, I'm gonna need you to come over here real quick.
Jason, did you not hear me? I said I was in an emergency.
I'm having a heart attack.
What?
I'm on the floor right now. I'm having a heart attack.
Well, what are you calling me for? Call 911.
I don't have insurance, man.
Wait, so you call me instead?
Dude, you gotta get over here.
Dude, you live like 30 minutes away from me. I can't do that.
I'm losing my vision, dude. You gotta come over. Quick, Brandon, hurry.
Okay, just calm down. I'll be there in like 30 minutes, okay? Just wait there, okay?
Hurry! I should ask me for food.
Thank you. Jason!
Oh, hey, man! Come on in. Shut the door.
What the fuck? I thought you were having a heart attack.
Oh, no, I just said that to get you over here. I knew that would be the only way that you would come over. It's nice if I told you I was dying, so.
Yeah, I'm being serious. Seriously, that one here.
I mean, yeah, you're here. So.
Okay. Jesus Christ.
You got here quick, huh? That 405 is like so much better since the construction.
I'm gonna leave, Jason.
No, don't
Jason,
leave. Don't
you
leave.
Can't,
don't leave.
You can't just call me and say that you're having a heart attack.
Don't leave.
Say that you're having a heart attack if you need something small. Okay?
I
it doesn't
know.
Work like
you're
that.
You're right. You're right.
It really doesn't.
You're right. You're absolutely right. But you know what's great? Is you cared. You came when a friend needed you. And that is what makes today special. So.
I'm leaving.
No, don't leave. I need you to just, I just need you to do one thing for me, okay?
One thing and then you'll stop saying that you're having a heart attack every time you need something? Every time?
Have I done this before?
Multiple times.
Really?
Yep. And I don't know how I fall for it every time. Maybe it's because you're saying you're having a heart attack, but
That is not a good thing to do. Not a good friend. A good friend would not do that.
Not at all.
Once is okay.
Characteristics of a sociopath, really. But what do you need help with?
We've known that for a couple years now. I mean, you and I.
What do you need help with?
Okay, come here. Just do this one thing.
Okay, see that apartment over there?
Yeah.
Okay, I want you to go over there. My friend Ryan lives there. And all you gotta do is say, Jason is sorry.
What?
Just walk over there, super chill, just be super normal.
Okay.
Just be like, what up, dude? Jason is sorry. That's all you gotta do.
Why? What did?
Jeez,
why do you want me?
Jeez, what's with the questions?
That was one question. What did I say?
I think there was more than one question there.
No, it wasn't. But what do you? Why do you want me to do that? I don't understand. What did you do?
Where are you? Are you Alex Trebek? Is that who you are? What are you?
So.
Dan Rather?
I don't know.
Dan Rather's interview show? Like if he had an interview show?
Okay. I'm going to leave again if you want me to.
No, come on, don't leave again. Right, look, I'm sorry. Just go over there, you do this one thing for me, and come on.
The hell is that?
It's like a kid day, my kids do this. And then that's how they get their way.
Okay. Daddy. Don't do that face ever again, we'll do it. I'll do it. Okay, Jesus Christ.
Oh wait.
What?
When you're over there, just don't upset him because he might clock you in the mouth.
Any other fun facts you want to tell me?
About this?
Yeah.
No, nothing about this. No.
All right, cool. I'll be back.
Hi.
Hello.
Look, you don't know me, but I'm a friend of your neighbor, Jason.
Okay.
And, what?
Can I do something for you?
All right, look. He sent me over here to tell you something. He sent me to tell you that he's sorry.
What?
He sent me over to tell you that he's sorry.
Okay, so he sent you to tell me that he's sorry.
Yeah.
Okay, and why couldn't he just do that himself?
Because he's a coward?
Okay, so here's what I want you to do, since you're clearly his little messenger boy here. Okay, you tell Jason that not only do I not accept his apology, but now I'm actually angrier at him because he sent some teenager with Vans and a 70s hairdo. He sent a guy like that to do the apologizing for him. I don't respect that. So you tell Jason that if he wants to apologize to me, he better do it to my face, okay?
Yep. I think I got it all in brain. So I'm going to take off.
Great. Thanks.
Cheers.
Oh, and one more thing.
Yeah.
Go fuck yourself.
Cool.
Oh, hey, man. How'd it go?
Oh, great. Really good, yeah. He liked the effort that you put in your apology, and he thinks Saul's forgiven now. So, yeah, everything's good.
He said that?
Nope. Not at all. He said the opposite, actually. But I don't know what you were really expecting going over there, having me go over there. So why can't you just do that yourself?
I just can't.
Why? Why?
Because I can't.
You keep saying you can't.
I can't.
Why can't you?
Because.
What did you do to him? I don't understand what's so.
I slept with his girlfriend. His ex-girlfriend.
What?
I saw her the other night and, you know, got really drunk and then it's like, you know, went home with her.
Okay, well, how long were they dating?
Took it to the limit.
How long were they dating?
Like, I don't know. It was like 5 years.
Jesus, man. Well, no wonder he's fucking... Okay, well, why can't you just... You wanted me to go over there to apologize for something that you did wrong, then. That seems to be what's happening, right?
Wait a minute. I didn't do anything wrong. They're broken up.
Do you think maybe from his perspective you did something wrong? Maybe?
I don't know. I don't know his perspective. What does that mean? His perspective? What am I, a mind reader? His, I don't get it.
Okay. Do you like this guy?
What do you mean?
Do you like him? Do you have a relationship with him? Did you used to? Do you currently?
Yeah,
do?
He's great. We write songs together.
Okay, that's great. All right, then
about starting a band.
Yeah. Okay.
So that's definitely on hold.
Well, then, if you want that to continue, you gotta go apologize.
But again, I don't feel like I did anything wrong.
It does not matter. Doesn't matter if you don't think that you did anything wrong. Okay. Clearly, he was hurt by what you did. Right. I mean, obviously. So you don't get to decide how he feels about something that you did to him.
Stop the millennial garbage. You guys are just out of control. My feelings, their feelings, I wonder, oh, I don't want to hurt anybody because I was born in the 90s.
Jesus. Okay. You know what, man? Just suck it up and go apologize to him, okay? Because you have to sometimes put your dignity away because that's what a man does. Jason. That's what a man does.
What's up? Where'd you just go?
Nowhere. Just forget it. Look, I gotta go.
Hi, this is Angie. I'm not at the phone right now, but call back later and maybe I will be.
Hey. Look, I don't know how to do this, but I'm just gonna come out and say it. I'm sorry, Angie. I'm sorry for what I said to your brother, and I can't change the way he feels about that, but if you can just let him know that I'm really sorry if I hurt his feelings, and it wasn't my intent. And I know that this might sound like some sort of pseudo-apology. It isn't. I'm just really sorry it took me this long to figure this out. So call me later on, and maybe we can get some coffee or something in the week. All right. Bye, Angie.